sign of great vacation and maturity for someone, especially so young, to have such a strong focus and work ethic. So without further ado, I'd like to give this award to Madison. At this time, we are going to be passing the donation baskets around for to help support our program, and your contributions help keep these concerts free, help provide scholarships for our students, it purchases new music, and it helps us to update and maintain all the instruments that we rent to the majority of our students. So we are happy to take any of the green stuff in your wallet if you have that. You can also write a check to UBYO, or you can also go online and donate through our website. On our website page, then there's a donation option, so you can also do that. At this time, we are setting up for our pre-beginning advanced students. So these are students that have been playing a year or more, and just that next level up, and they are harmonizing, they're still playing out of our book that we call All for Strings, that both our first two classes use, but their last piece is what we call sheet music. They're used to playing out of a book, and most of their songs are maybe two or three lines long. And then this year they got this piece of sheet music. This is one whole song, so this is very long to them. Their arms were pretty tired at first. You can see we've been thinking about maybe three lines and have to take a little break. But they have worked through it, and they are ready to play this for you. And they are also playing harmony, which means that the first violins are playing one set of notes, the second violins another set, the third violins another, and then our cellos another note. And so that is very difficult to do when we start out, because your ear tends to get pulled to somebody else playing something different, and it can be a little bit confusing. So these are our pre-beginning advanced students, like I said. We're going to take just a minute more to finish passing the baskets around before we bring our
Thank you.
Okay, looks like we're good. If you can bring those backstage to one of our board members, that would be great. Okay, so again, this is our pre-beginning advanced orchestra, and I'm going to welcome to the stage first-year teacher Rayleigh Jordan.
Thank you.
Well, this is our beginning orchestra behind me, and this is our largest orchestra. I think it was about 54 students when I last counted. And this is a fun group. I have always enjoyed conducting this group, but this year I turn the little babies over to Miss Taylor Bennett. And she has been conducting and working with them, and it's been great to have her back. She took a year off kind of exploring some other options and happily met with me after our spring concert and said, I missed this, I want to come back. And I was like, yes, thank you. Love have her. She grew up playing in the orchestras that I conducted, and so it's been a lot of fun to have her back. So Taylor, take it away.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, it is time to announce the Student Achievement Award for the beginning class. So first off, I would like to call Maddie Newton up here. So Maddie, I have known, I believe I taught her the very first year that she started playing violin, and I have gotten the privilege of watching her grow up through the program for many years, and also be involved in a billion different sports and school choirs and all of these things. And it has been really amazing to just watch her grow into this very accomplished young woman. And I'm super proud of all that she does and her work ethic and just her joy for music and her commitment to making beautiful music and having fun while she does it. So this award is for Maddie.
Thank you.
I got a little off script tonight, and I forgot to explain why we're playing Christmas music in January. So for years, the kids have asked, oh, can we play a Christmas song? Can we play a Christmas song? And I've always said, no, our concert's a month after Christmas. Everyone's tired of Christmas music by then. Well, this year I finally caved, and pre-beginning advance and all of our orchestras above that are all playing one Christmas song, so we hope we don't drive you out with Christmas music in January. But it's been a lot of fun to go through those pieces and rehearse them. So this is our intermediate group behind me, and I'm going to go off script again. Madison, can you go grab the flowers and Miss Alyssa's name on them? Alyssa, can you come up here to serve us? So Alyssa, I've known since she was little tiny, and her family have just been a blessing to me over the years. She was a student for a long time, and she's been a teacher off and on in our program. And this year, some other things have kind of taken her out of a full-time teaching position. But she still has pretty much any time I've asked filled in for me or for another teacher. She's left some sectionals. She's helped our third violin section out. And I just want to say I'm so grateful and thankful that you were my student and that you are now my friend. So. Just wanted to say thank you for all she's done for the program, so thank you. So I picked out some of our music. I picked it out over the summertime, and I've gotten to the point where picking music is not really fun anymore. For me, it's very difficult because I've been doing this long enough that I played so many pieces, and I'm trying to remember when we did that last, when we did this one, and what level is this good for, because unfortunately the editors do not agree on what a intermediate piece looks like. It could be something that pre-beginning could play, or it could be something that only advanced could play. So there's a very big range in how they mark the levels for each piece of music. And so it's become quite challenging, but this year, two of our pieces, our Christmas song is Mary, Did You Know? And then we are playing a pop tune, Shut Up and Dance. And I thought, oh, these are going to be really fun. And then we started practicing them, and I went, oh, boy. Both those pieces have a lot of syncopation, which, if you are not a musician, when we play bum, 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 that's playing on the beat. When we go bum, 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 on the off beats, playing funky between the beats. And it's very, very tricky, and some of the rhythms have been quite difficult. And then on both those pieces, each section has kind of their own part of the melody, and I can't really help one section, and so I just have to stand here and hope that everybody knows their part and that they're all following and working and listening together. Where some pieces, if the cellos have a big part, I can kind of look at them and pay attention to them, and everyone else has to keep track. But both those pieces have been quite challenging, but they've been a lot of fun, and so we are going to start intermediate group with two soloists, three actually, Rayleigh and Rory Jordan, brother and sister, and then Ann and Ulrich on cello. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is our intermediate student award. And so I'm going to ask these two students to come forward, Eden Furman and Rebecca Coleman. Moved up to beginning and intermediate and has done very, very well with the challenge. Quite a big step for the 2 and 3 from what you were doing before. And she's just always very eager and very attentive when she's at class. And I love watching her play because she just really gets into it. So congratulations, and I appreciate all your work. You should never tell me you don't want to be on stage. Rebecca is new to the program this year. She's been in Roseburg 2 years, 3 years, 1.5 years, and had moved over here from Bend, and I had heard about her from some of the other students, and I kept saying, get her to come to orchestra. And so the Jordans worked on her and her parents, and we had a little meet and greet one day at my house. And she reluctantly at first agreed to come to orchestra. It's just been really fun to watch her. She had been away from lessons for a bit, and so she is doing lessons again. And it's been really fun to watch the progress and her love of music kind of come back. So I appreciate all your effort, and you never have to be nervous again on stage. You did it great. Thank you. Our instruments do not light. When we got here this afternoon, it was fairly cool, and as the lights stay on and the people show up, the temperature goes up, and they're very sensitive to us. We're having to do some adjusting with our team. So this is our advanced orchestra, and these kids, most of them are in private lessons. Most of them have been playing for a number of years, and we have a lot of fun in this group. I'm pretty sure you can tell from the first piece that it was a class favorite. Gannon has been asking for this piece for how many years? I don't know, a long time. And so we brought it back for her to play this year. So we're going to start off with Viva La Vida.
Thank you. Thank you.
Lots of different things going on there. Addison plays the violin, plays the piano, plays a marching band, has a 4.0, and she teaches. Crazy. So let's give another round of applause. So it is time to give our Student Achievement Award for our advanced students. And I spoke about Melissa earlier this evening, and I think one of the things that's most enjoyable about doing this and being here now, this summer will be 26 years that I live here, is watching the students grow up. And as Taylor talked about Maddie earlier, develop into beautiful human beings and just do, they have just so much potential with their lives. It's fun to watch them and see where life takes them. This person started lessons fairly young. I forgot to tell you what it was. Come here. And she kind of really just followed on the tails of her buddy Maya, who used to play here. And she wanted to be kind of like Maya, and Maya played the cello. So Anna played the cello. And, it's fun. It's been a lot of fun to have her in the program. And she's been my student, but it's been fun really the last year or so to kind of develop more of a friendship with you. And I'm excited to see her life. Thank you. Thank you for all your hard work. So we are going to finish out the evening with the Fidelio by Beethoven. This was another class favorite, I think you can tell with just the energy that they put into this. And so, especially the very end of it, there's a lot of very fast, high stuff going on. But I just would like to say thank you again for joining us this evening. We appreciate your support. If you have any questions, you can look at our website. You can contact us through that, my phone number, or reach out to one of the students or a board member. We would love to have your support in the future, so please mark your calendar for our spring concerts, and I believe next year's concert dates are also on in the program. So thank you again to all of our students and families, and appreciate you, and have a safe drive home this evening. Thank you for coping with me.
Thank you.